I was taught that you never go to the store when you need something.
Right.
It's like, you don't want to have to go to the store when you need toilet paper.
Right. I know.
Right. Yeah. And you want to have a store of it. And to this day, you know, my parents, they have a, you know, they store essentials like that, whether it's paper towel, whether it's toilet paper, things like that, Kleenexes. And it's because they've seen people, and this is just another money principle, is like, if you need to go buy something when you need it, you're going to pay way more than you would have otherwise.
Well, and it puts pressure and just makes you be anxious and focus on something that really is not profitable. This is BetterWealth with Caleb Williams. Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of the BetterWealth Breakdown, where we're breaking down concepts, ideas, and thoughts from around the world to help you live a more intentional life. And today's episode, we're going to talk about why toilet paper can teach you a thing or two about emergency funds. I really hope that's the title, because I think that it would actually get people to start like clicking on our show and being like, I want to listen to this.
That's right. So I was thinking about this the other day of when COVID hit, what was everybody freaking out about, what was in the news for felt like weeks, was the toilet paper shortage and how people were buying way more than they ever needed.
Yep. I actually have a confession.
Uh-oh.
I was at a conference during this time when everything shut down, like the NBA, like I was like, holy. And then someone, like I think someone that I knew, like went to the store and they're like, everyone's like cleared everything out of the store. So I was at a hotel and I looked, they had an extra toilet paper. No joke. I actually took that toilet paper and put it in. So I want you to know the reason I did that is I think we did not stock up on our toilet paper. So that was a good example of how your dad will, if he's listening to this or when you're listening to this, he's going to be very disappointed in his son.
Well, as long as we're being honest around here, I had a private stash. so the rest of the house was struggling and I was taking care of it. And so that's a perfect segue though, because that's the way I was brought up is, I was taught that you never go to the store when you need something.
Right.
It's like, you don't want to have to go to the store when you need toilet paper.
Right. I know.
Right. Yeah. And you want to have a store of it. And to this day, you know, my parents, they have a, you know, they store essentials like that, whether it's paper towel, whether it's toilet paper, things like that, Kleenexes. And it's because they've seen people, and this is just another money principle, is like, if you need to go buy something when you need it, you're going to pay way more than you would have otherwise.
Well, and it puts pressure and just makes you be anxious and focus on something that really is not profitable.
Yep.
I mean, this is actually a really good example of why emergency funds are important. Is here I'm thinking toilet paper when I was at a conference to help me be a better speaker.
Yep. Yeah, and so the relator is the emergency fund. You never want to think that you're going to need it, but when you do need it, you want to have it, and yet so few people have one.
Yep.
And so that's the relator, and talk about efficiency. Back to the toilet paper, you're probably going to the store for a single thing at that point.
Yep.
Instead of actually planning forward and being efficient in your shopping trip, or you're going to multiple stores across town and all that kind of stuff. And so the idea of the emergency fund is, I would wager that almost everybody has heard that you should have an emergency fund. How much money do you think you should have saved up?
So here's my point. If you're an entrepreneur or you know an entrepreneur, send them this episode. Because I think if you are in a business and that business is not only providing your income, but providing future potential growth, like make sure that you have at least 6 months. I really think the target is a year. Everyone thinks I'm crazy, but now when we look back, if you had a year's worth of savings, you could be in a totally different position. Your headspace could not be focused on, am I going to have money for this thing to make rent or to get my mortgage? It could be focused on, how are we going to make sure that this business weathers the storm and maybe takes advantage of opportunities? And so the reason I'm so adamant about this is entrepreneurs and investors tend to be the worst, because they feel like their money's sitting at 0%, or if you use the and asset, they want to like leverage their and asset and not have their money just sit. And I'm telling you, there's something about having some money sit, and it just brings peace of mind, and at least have that mindset, because when everything hits the fan, there's no guarantees.
Right.
And so, yeah, that's something that's just a really big deal.
Well, and I want you to just picture this. During the hysteria and the news and everybody saying, you know, there's this run on toilet paper, think of the people like my parents who didn't have to worry about that. That's a massive peace of mind. And the same is true if you have an emergency fund, or for those who have had one or have been using it during this time. I bet you they didn't think that they would ever have to use it, but I bet you they're really glad that they did have it and are able to use that and be able to maybe not only survive, but thrive through this time. Because that's what we're seeing is really in the business world, it's feast or famine right now. It's either the ones that were set up and actually stockpiled money are able to pivot and grow through this. And a lot of doors are shuttering because they didn't have an emergency fund.
Yep. The person that has the gold makes the rules. That's the golden rule that we a lot of times live by, just because it's just the reality. And we've seen this and the sad reality is, Dan, a lot of people may listen to this. A lot of people may have gone through a scare, but when this all comes back to normal, if it comes back to normal, we just tend to forget. It's very human of us. And so send this to someone that needs to hear it. And hopefully this made you laugh. Thank you so much for listening to the Better Wealth Podcast. It would mean the world to me if you could hit subscribe, leave a review, and share this with the people that you know and love.